Are you trying to establish your brand as a thought leader? Start a podcast. Invite industry experts to be guests on your show and watch your brand become the prime resource for decision makers in your industry. Learn more at sweetfishmedia.com.
You're listening to B2B Growth, a daily podcast for B2B leaders. We've interviewed names you've probably heard before, like Gary Vaynerchuk and Simon Sinek, but you've probably never heard from the majority of our guests. That's because the bulk of our interviews aren't with professional speakers and authors. Most of our guests are in the trenches leading sales and marketing teams. They're implementing strategy. They're experimenting with tactics. They're building the fastest growing B2B companies in the world. My name is James Carberry. I'm the founder of Sweetfish Media, a podcast agency for B2B brands, and I'm also one of the co-hosts of this show. When we're not interviewing sales and marketing leaders, you'll hear stories from behind the scenes of our own business. We'll share the ups and downs of our journey as we attempt to take over the world. Just kidding. Well, maybe. Let's get into the show.
Hey, everybody. Before we get rolling, we wanted to tell you about another podcast you should probably check out, the Sales Experience Podcast, hosted by our friend, Jason Cutter. On the Sales Experience Podcast, Jason shares tips and lessons to help you create a sales experience that will turn more prospects into customers. Whether you're new to sales, a veteran, or lead a sales team, if your goal is to impact the lives of your customers, then this podcast is likely for you. Our favorite episode is number 97, Professionals Don't Ask for the Sale. Now, let's get into the show. Welcome back to B2B Growth. I'm Logan Lyles with Sweetfish Media. Today is another episode in our Five Things series where we're talking to your fellow marketers about the five things they can't live without. I'm joined today by a repeat guest, Lindsay Cournoyer. She is the VP of Marketing over at Anoxify. Lindsay, welcome back to the show. How's it going today?
I'm doing well. Thanks, Logan. Thanks for having me. I'm happy to be on again.
Yeah, absolutely. You and Nikki had a great chat last time you were on the show. Just sounded like you guys were having a ton of fun. And as we were kicking off this series, I think this is episode 5 or 6 in this series, I thought you're probably going to have some fun things to share with folks on this five thing series.
Here's hoping.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, let's jump off with number one. It's around your exercise routine. And this has been a common one in just a few episodes in this series so far.
Yeah. So one thing I honestly do not know what I would do without is my Peloton bike. My husband gave it to me as a Christmas gift a year ago. And as someone who likes to spin and used to spend hours at the gym pre-children, it's literally changed my life because I can get up before work, before the kids, and I can jump on. And even if it's just for 10, 15, 20 minutes, which is really all I do most days, it's just that opportunity to set your mind right, get a little sweat going, start your day off on the right foot. So I find those like micro bursts that I can get on my Peloton just really help me get my day off on the right foot.
Yeah, absolutely. I was talking to Natalie Lambert over at Instart, and she was just raving about her Peloton in the first episode in this series. Have you found that the way they're doing gamification and things like that is something that you get into, or is it just more the core, like, hey, it's a solid bike, I can get into it very, very quickly and easily, you know, like you said, without, you know, I'm with you with two kids at the house. And so anything that you can do before the kids get up is usually pretty helpful, whether it's your exercise or work routine, whatever it might be.
Yeah. So you know what? I'm not someone who really buys into the gamification. I'm never trying to, you know, be the top of the leaderboard because I don't need to work that hard. There are people on there who are like crazy. Yeah. I really just do it for myself and to get a sweat going. But my husband, for example, is into the gamification. Literally, he will spin so hard, he almost, you know, yaks. He's like uber competitive. So if you've got that personality type, it totally works. But for me, I just like, you know, a little light sweat and I'm good to go.
Yeah, I love it. We've all got our different levels of competitiveness. So going from exercise to the other end of the spectrum, when you need to calm down, there's an app that's been part of your regular routine that makes your list of five things you can't live without, right?
Yes. And that is the Calm app. And I'm sure a lot of listeners use it there's Headspace, there's the Calm app, there's a ton of options out there. But the girl's voice, the main narrator on the Calm app and their meditations is a girl named Tamara Levitt. And there's just something about her voice that literally knocks me out. It just puts me in this crazy calm state. So every night before I go to bed, I'll listen to a meditation or a sleep story. And it honestly just lets me kind of turn off my brain. As a VP of marketing, mom of two little kids, it's always racing up there. And I just need that moment of kind of calm and peace before I go to sleep. And I find that the Calm app really transitions me into being ready to sleep. And literally, you know, while you're supposed to stay awake for the whole meditation, I rarely make it to the end. So you're supposed to do it sitting and I do it laying down in bed. So I am not, you know, the world's best meditator, but I do find that the Calm app really is key to getting a good night's rest for me, which gets into our third point.
Yeah, absolutely. And it kind of goes along with your point of, hey, I'm not competitive. I'm not looking at, hey, I've got to do this right. I've got to do it the way everybody else is doing it. But you found something that works for you, just like with your Peloton. I love it. You know, I can identify with that. Just your brain constantly going, you know, for me at Sweetfish, we're a distributed team. And so oftentimes, you know, work schedules can be pretty much flex. And for anybody else that works remotely or from home 100%, you know, they've probably realized like, there can be a lot of bleed over for good and for bad, right? And so I've heard people recommend the Headspace app, as you mentioned, Calm. I haven't, but I'm definitely going to check that out and see what my experience is going to be like with it, Lindsay. Yes. So as you alluded to a second ago, the Calm app is number two on your list. Number three is what the Calm app helps you do. So you are not one of those people that ascribes to this saying, you know, I'll sleep when I'm dead, right?
Oh no, I'm the opposite of that. So sleep is literally the key to my life. I cannot operate on less than, I would say, 8 hours of sleep, which, you know, some people think I'm crazy, but I come from a long line of sleepers. My mom is a champ sleeper. She naps every day. And luckily, you know, I inherited that. I don't have sleep issues, but protecting my sleep is really important to being my best every day and being a good mom and a good boss and a good marketer. I'm really protective over those 8 hours. And it's funny because on the Calm app, LeBron James just did a series and one of his sessions was about sleep. And I loved it. You got to check out that episode. But basically what he said is, as a professional athlete, and someone who knows that sleep is so important, he actually schedules sleep in his calendar. So on game days, he has his time blocked where he takes his nap. And even for bedtime, you know, he schedules his bedtime and he hits it consistently and he's protective over that. So I just love that. And I follow something quite similar. And it's really just, you know, I know myself and I know that unless I'm well rested, I just can't perform like I need to at the office and at home. So it's really important to me that I get that rest.
Yeah. If it's good enough for LeBron, it's probably good enough for the rest of us to reach peak performance, right? Totally. Awesome. So speaking of peak performance, one of the things that also made your list of five things you can't live without, Lindsay, is your executive coach. And I'm hearing, I think, more folks who are finding benefit from this, but I don't think it's something that, as I'm talking to people every single day, that it's part of just, you know, their normal work life. So I'd love to hear from you what some of the benefits have been and why it made your list of your top five.
Yeah. So I would say, you know, in my work life, just like LeBron needs a coach, you know, to play ball, you know, when you get to the VP ranks and you become an executive, and I have been in the role for a year here at Anoxify, making that transition from director to VP is a really big jump. The responsibility, the pressure, a whole new peer group, who may be a lot more seasoned and experienced than you. So I sought out an executive coach on my own, and I was able to connect with this awesome girl named Julie Zato, who works for Demand Spring. And she and I had a call just to kind of feel each other out, and we really hit it off. And I'd say we chat now about once a month, and it's just, I call her actually my work therapist. And it's the greatest thing, because you really get that third party objective view. They don't know you, they don't know who you work with, but they're there to listen, coach you through. So we talk about all kinds of things from, you know, challenges I'm having with the team to how to motivate them, how to structure them, what best in class marketing teams are doing, how to manage, you know, my peers, how to present to the board. So having her guidance and coaching as someone who was a CMO has really been invaluable to me.
That's awesome. That is really great to hear. And shout out to Julie there. I love that. All right, let's round it out. Another person in your life makes your list of your top five things you can't live without, right, Lindsay?
Yes. And that is my partner, Jesse, my husband. So, you know, it may sound cheesy or obvious, but I have to say, without his support, I could not do what I do. My job is very demanding. You know, you have to set boundaries, but it could literally take up all of my time. I've also got two little girls and two dogs who I love dearly. So, you know, you go from this crazy busy day to going home and parenting, and without a partner like him, I just can't see myself doing what I do. He's incredibly supportive of my career. Our careers are equal. He owns his own business. I'm a VP of marketing. We share all parenting responsibilities. We both do pickups, drop-offs. We share the housework. He's the cook. I'm the cleaner. You know, we know our roles, we have our strengths, but we share it. And honestly, without his support and encouragement, it would be really hard to do everything and balance everything. But when you have that person who supports you and is really in your corner, it makes it a lot easier and more enjoyable along the way.
I've got nothing to add. You said it so very well, Lindsay. I love it. And as a great shout out to your husband here on your five things that you shared today. I love the thought that you've put into it, the things that you've shared today. I'm going to go and download the Calm apps and check out. You said the LeBron episode is within the Calm app. There's one with him there. Okay.
Yes.
That is now on my list. I think you've given some other folks things to think about, whether they're, you know, making that jump from director to VP and maybe looking for some ways that they can manage that, as you have with an executive coach, or thinking about maybe they're a little bit behind on their New Year's resolution and maybe the Peloton's the thing for them. Mm-hmm. I just love this peek behind the curtain at a lot of great marketing leaders we've had on the podcast and sharing some tips and tricks and things that are helping them on their journey in life and at work. And you've definitely done that today, Lindsay. If anybody listening to this isn't yet connected with you, what's your preferred social handle? What's the best way for them to reach out and stay connected with you?
Yeah, well, I am all about LinkedIn. So you can find me on LinkedIn, Lindsay Cournoyer. There is one other in the world, but you'll see me, my picture, Anoxify. And then if you want to check out Anoxify, it's at anoxify.com. But yeah, LinkedIn is the best spot.
Absolutely. Lindsay, thank you so much for joining us on the show again.
Thanks a lot, Logan.
I hate it when podcasts incessantly ask their listeners for reviews, but I get why they do it, because reviews are enormously helpful when you're trying to grow a podcast audience. So here's what we decided to do. If you leave a review for B2B Growth in Apple Podcasts and email me a screenshot of the review to james@sweetfishmedia.com, I'll send you a signed copy of my new book, Content-Based Networking, How to Instantly Connect with Anyone You Want to Know. We get a review, you get a free book. We both win.